Hunter Moore, he is a young American who is working as a teacher in Cairo. Now, he and a friend shot this video for CNN iReport while helping the wounded in Tahrir Square on Wednesday. He plans to jump in again today if necessary. Hunter Moore is joining us by phone in Cairo. And Hunter, thank you so much for being with us here. First and foremost, we're taking a look at these extraordinary pictures that you sent in. How did you get involved in this? Were you actually on the scene, on the ground, when this started to erupt?
Yeah, we've been out there since last Tuesday, the 25th, and sort of assessed the need of what we could do to help. And we realized that we could get some medical supplies and some food to distribute.
What kind of injuries did you see?
I beg your pardon?
What kind of injuries did you see? Were they serious?
It was mostly head injuries, and not easily 90% head injuries. Some that required much more medical attention than we could offer. A lot of it was, you know, many men needed stitches, but it was mostly head injuries, and a lot of them had came two or three times because they'd get patched up and they'd run right back out there and come back with another head injury just minutes later.
And this was from what I understand, there were machetes, there were rocks. So
mostly rocks.
And what were people saying to you? Was there a sense of despair? Were they determined to, you said they went back out and would fight again?
Yeah, they went back out over and over again. They were screaming about freedom, screaming about democracy. There was a lot of solidarity in the crowd. They were thanking me. It was a really an amazing time to be out there.
And Hunter, in light of your experience here, you've been in Cairo for quite some time. Do you have a sense that it's time for you to go, that you should leave this country?
Not quite. You know, I'm kind of just this past day we haven't been able to get down to Tahrir just due to some rumors, and we tried to go, but we were warned by many people that they were being pretty hostile to foreigners. So we've set up kind of an ad hoc food drive and also a Facebook group called Medical Aid for Cairo that we're trying to organize getting medical aid and food to the people of Cairo that need it right now.